and I'm not getting into the part about the, you know, widespread voter fraud. You're correct. Wasn't found.
Wait, did he just say widespread voter fraud doesn't exist? That's Republican Representative Alan Powell speaking at the hearing for House Bill 531, a new voter suppression bill in Georgia that he sponsors.
And I'm not getting into the part about the, you know, widespread voter fraud. You're correct. It wasn't found. It's just in a lot of people's mind that there was.
Huh. I guess he really did.
Yesterday, HB 531 was filed and given a hearing on the same day. It was not even available on the Georgia Assembly website before it was on the agenda for the Special Committee for Election Integrity meeting. With little less than 2 hours, there is no way legislators can properly prepare for a hearing on this bill.
The legislature is considering a bill poised to create unnecessary barriers and burdens on voters that disproportionately impact racial minorities, low-income, elderly, rural, disabled, and student voters.
After a record number of Black voters came out to vote during the 2020 presidential election in Georgia, Georgia is now being blindsided with a new bill that's being steamrolled into the state legislature that would continue to suppress the votes of Black people. My name is Alyssa Bernardino, and today's topic is voter suppression in Georgia. With very little public notice given, and with hours between when the bill was introduced and when they held a hearing on it, it seems pretty obvious that they're doing something shady. The bill attempts to strengthen our democracy by preventing voter fraud that would occur during things like absentee voting, despite there being no evidence that there is large-scale fraud. Now, voting rights advocacy groups are calling on Georgia's state legislature to put a hold on this bill until they've reviewed the 48 pages that it entails. HB 531 would limit voting rights by ending early Sunday voting, which is a time when many Black churches will hold their souls to the polls, get out the vote drive. Other provisions of the bill would give voters less time to request mail-in ballots and election officials less time to send them out. It would also throw out ballots that are cast in the wrong precinct and restrict the use of mail-in ballot drop boxes. It should be noted that when North Carolina attempted to pass the same kind of laws in 2013, an appeals court struck it down and said the bill targeted Black people with almost surgical precision. This new bill in Georgia is very clearly a response to Black voter turnout in the 2020 presidential election. In the November general election, Black voters used early voting on weekends at a higher rate than whites in 43 of 50 of the state's largest counties. We should also take a good look at who's sponsoring this bill. Representative Barry Fleming.
But how'd you feel when you found your desk and it just sat in the chair?
It felt like it fit. It was great. I found my desk and see what other representatives are sitting around me. And it's really a good seat as far as the House is concerned, so I'm very thankful for the Speaker for that.
In 2015, the Majority White Elections Board of Hancock County, Georgia, was sued after they attempted to purge Black voters from registration rolls prior to county elections. The board sent law enforcement to serve court summons challenging voter eligibility, and almost all of them were Black. Voter participation fell by 40% that year, and Sparta, Georgia elected a white mayor for the first time in over 30 years. Fleming, the county attorney at the time, said the elections board was only trying to restore order to an electoral process tainted by corruption and incompetence, and that the lawsuit was overblown. And so to the party that likes to claim election fraud every time they see a mail-in ballot, or election fraud every time their candidate doesn't win, this is a low blow, but not surprising. They just don't care. They're not trying to hide it anymore. It's very obvious given the time frame of this bill and its proceedings in the state legislature. It seems clear why the executive director of Common Cause Georgia called this Jim Crow with a suit and tie. My name is Alyssa Bernardino. Thank you for watching.